Dans l'océan, il y a bien entendu des poissons et des
pêcheurs. In the ocean, there are fishers and
fishermen.
For a long time, fishery management only looked at fishermen and fishes, but there are other organisms being affected by fishing activities in the oceans. Mammals, marine mammals, sea lions or sea birds. And we're going to focus on seabirds. In many marine ecosystems, a large variety of seabird populations is observed. Let's take the coast of Peru. Here we have the evolution of the number of cormorant, gannets and pelicans, and the quantity of anchovies being landed during the 20th and 21st century, and these fishes are their main prey. Many elements allow to explain for variability in the bird population, sometimes administrative. In 1946, the Peru state created natural reserves to protect areas where the birds make their nests, and the population doubled. In the late 50s, an industrial fishery developed, which now fishes the main prey, Peruvian anchovy. Also, climate events such as the El Niño storm had an impact on abundance, distribution, and accessibility of anchovies for the birds. It is extremely difficult to discriminate the respective influence of the various factors, fishery, administrative, or climatic factors, and studies are necessary to understand the contribution of each. Therefore, research has been organized to understand three types of data. We need to know exactly the number of seabirds. Either they are counted from the ground or from the air with airplanes or UAVs. But also, in order to study the birds, we need to use dynamic models in order to understand what happens where we have no data or when we have no data. We also need to gather information on the reproductive success of these birds. And finally, we can ban the birds in order to understand whether they are loyal to their normal nesting site or for how many years they live. Next, we need to understand what they feed on. There are two methods. Either we look directly in the stomach or the stomach content based on the little balls they spit out, because in these little balls we can find small hard fragments coming from fishes, otoliths, which have a specific shape and allow to understand which fishes were eaten. And we can use blood samples or feather samples to find the isotopic ratio of several compounds such as carbon, nitrogen and mercury, so that we can understand and the feeding habits of the birds for the last few weeks. Finally, we need to understand where the birds feed. Interaction with fishing only happens when the two types of organisms are present in the same area. This research has developed over the last decades thanks to technological progress, some systems have been miniaturized, GPSs, diving technology, and miniaturized geolocation devices that use the sun rays. Now, there are several methods. The first method, the first way to account for death is accidental capture. Sometimes the birds are caught by accident, and accidental capture is obviously that it decreases the number of birds in some species. This was very frequent in the drifting nets, which were ruled out and banished in 1999, but they were replaced by a long line activity. A long line is a fishing line with hooks. The bait is a fish, and unfortunately, albatrosses dive under the sea because they want to feed on the bait, and they are caught accidentally in that case. In the drifting nets, hundreds of thousands of birds used to be caught accidentally. Nowadays, the numbers are lower, but long-line accidental catches are still
de pêcheurs
frequent and many scientists and fishermen try to mitigate the danger. Accidental catches also have unexpected impacts. A selection pressure on the population of birds. A very interesting study was conducted on albatross in Crozet. This is a population with a strange behavior because the number of birds tends to increase, although they are in high danger of being accidentally caught. Researchers tried to understand why the population increased rather than decreased, and they found that it was a matter of personality of the birds and the proportion of different personalities. Animals, like human beings, have different characters and personalities. Some are shy, some are more adventurous, some are more aggressive. Now, in the interaction with fishermen and fisheries, the most curious individuals are the ones that go closest to the long lines and get caught. There is a higher risk of them being caught. After a few years, natural selection will therefore favor the shy individuals. And by taking this parameter into consideration, the researchers were able to understand and explain why the Crozet albatrosses were actually increasing in numbers rather than decreasing. But fishing can have some unexpected consequences on bird population. Take the Cape Town gannet feeding on along the coast of South Africa. Researchers have shown that normally these birds feed on small pelagic fishes, which are interesting because they are have a high content in lipids and they have highly nutritive values. However, because these fishes were caught by the fishing boat, the birds developed alternative strategies and they started feeding on fishes being rejected by some fishing ships. However, those fishes were not so fat, and although the adults could thrive on these fishes, their offspring could not, and there was a serious threat. This phenomenon was called dustbin feeding. The third type of interaction between fisheries and birds is direct competition for the prey. Globally, we can very well imagine that if fisheries take many of the fishes which normally serve as prey for the seabirds will be in difficulty to feed themselves and feed their offspring. In order to confirm this assumption in a quantitative manner, several researchers met in several places in order to compare data from 14 species spread over 7 ecosystems. They compared the reproductive success and the abundance of prey fishes. Now, interestingly, for all the species in all 7 ecosystems, they were able to show a relationship, a similarity, whereby reproductive success decreases as the abundance of prey decreases, but there is a non-proportional effect. There is a threshold below which we should never go if we want to be able to preserve the seabird populations. Competition may also take place, or rather, be based on a different component locally. Of course, a seabird needs to have fish in the sea to be able to feed on, but also the fish should be located in the right place. And during reproduction, birds are vulnerable because they must feed themselves, but they also must feed their offspring. And because the offspring require the presence of one of the two parents, the other parent must be able to find food in a relatively small range around the nesting colony. A research in Peru compared the travel of gamets and the activity all around, the fishing activity all around the colony. In orange, we have the bird flight, and we also see in red and black the fisheries location. Birds had to increase the distance they traveled to find fish, and researchers showed that fishing was a reason why the birds had to travel a longer distance. And by quantifying respective need of birds and fishermen, the researchers showed that in order to feed the colony, 200 tons of anchovies had to be available around the colony every day, whereas the fishing ships could take 50,000 tons tons a day in the same area. We see on the right-hand side the effect before and after fishing activity. The red stains represent the schools of fishes. And at the bottom, we have the same area immediately following fishing activities. So there are interactions between fishing and birds under different forms. The next question is, what can we do to address these problems? Some solutions have been suggested for accidental catches. Some technical solutions are already being applied so that albatross and other such like birds are attracted and caught by fishing lines. Lead weights can be used to make the line drop further down so that the birds can no longer have access to the lines. Also, visual and sound signals can be used to keep the birds away from the lines, or the lines can also be used at night so that the birds are not attracted. In order to also adjust to the behavioral changes of the birds and dustbin feeding habits, some countries have simply banned the measure consisting in throwing the fishes back into the sea. Countries like Norway, for instance, are thinking about this solution, and other countries have already implemented such solutions. Finally, we can also decide on fishing quotas, taking into consideration the local birds. Needs. The research presented earlier have established that at least one-third of the maximum store of fishes observed throughout history should be left in the sea to guarantee that birds can feed on those fishes and reproduce themselves. And in order to make sure that the fishes are available for the seabird population, we may suggest that protected marine areas are set up permanently or temporarily all around the nesting area so that the birds can population can be maintained.